You can walk away from the stage, young man, but show business will always be. Down there.
dare you violate the sanctuary of the Phantom? Stop, or your next step will be your last.
No.
Anything but that. Oh, treacherous child. You shall pay for angering the men.
Yeah, whatever. Now just stay put so I can come punch and unmask you. Okay, Phantom, it's time to find out who you really are. What? I totally guessed that.
Nuh-uh, you said it was Becky.
Okay, the jig is up, Phantom.
What? Why, I never! How dare you accuse me of being the rugged and romantic scoundrel that has thrilled and terrified audiences for years?
Yeah, I guess you're right. He's so agile and limber and thin. He could never be you.
Why, you? Of course it's me!
Well, it's time to hang up the cape, Tubbs, because your days of terrorizing the theater as the Phantom are over.
Maybe as the Phantom, but he's nothing compared to the full destructive force of an angry critic!
How can I say this and still sound cool? Sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me?
A terrible fight. fighter, not up to the task at hand. Just plain bad.
Now, how can I light that candle?
Pour hot beam across to kill him before he gets over here! Why didn't I bring my son? Kill him! Get him!
I shall happily retire while I'm still young.
finally, recognition for my acting talents.
Listen to him. Retreat!
Shut up, you fool! The battle is ours! Wellington is on the run. This is our moment of glory.
Oh, shut up, you loon.
The battle can't be won. We're gonna lose it.
I'm afraid you lost it years ago, Fred. Now pipe down over there. I am the orderly, and I run a quiet, peaceful, insane asylum. Understood? Oh, now see? You've disrupted Mr. Tagley's art therapy session.
Le jour de gloire est arrivé!
Whatever.
Why aren't you attacking?
How Chloe sneezed this one through that helmet, we'll never know.
Oh, good move, mate.
Where'd everybody go? Is everybody dead?
Greetings, Dr. Labotta.
Up to the secret laboratory, then, is it?
One moment. You're not Dr. Labotta. My eyes maybe have gone, but I would recognize the mad doctor anywhere.
He's got a stone-cold face a man doesn't easily forget.
He wears a beastly smock, covered in thick straps like an electric chair.
And in the place where his hand should be, there's nothing but a gleaming metal claw.
So if I'm not mistaken, you're not Dr. Labotta. You'd
thank you.
Let's take it to the chateau, boys!
Huh?
I need to re-
Effort?
Trouble.
Sounds like it's time something bad happened to our fine coach.
Well, let me tell you what our plan is.
Please, you have your plan, I have mine.
But
say no more.
So, any questions?
Is Elton okay?
Well, he'll be fully brained soon, I promise.
When he comes out, tell him I'm waiting for him down by the docks, okay?
Hey, do you want to help us save the... Typical. The end.
Okay, here's the plan. I'm gonna go get on the coach's radio and call for help.
See, now that's an excellent idea. Why can't everyone be so helpful?
Yeah, I modified the antenna, so now it broadcasts straight into outer space.
Oh, man. And that's why finding your brain in particular was my highest priority.
You know, I'll bet if JT wasn't so distracted, this wouldn't have happened. He's probably with that prissy little show pony right now.
No. Actually, I think her mind's on other things at the moment.
Hmm. Well, maybe I'll go see what's up. One of us at least should be guarding the sleeping quarters.
Agent Kruller?
What is the current situation?
I'm ready.
Okay,